What will we do with the historical Jesus? We've not examined all the evidence. We'll look at some more things in the future, perhaps in some future studies. But there is ample evidence, and we've examined ample evidence to cause us to realize there was a man who lived in Israel whose name was Jesus, and he died on a cross around AD 33. I want to share some words with you from F.F. Bruce. He said, "It is a curious fact that the historians have often been much readier to trust the New Testament records than have many theologians. Some writers may toy with the fancy of a Christ myth, but they do not do so on the ground of historical evidence. The historicity of Christ is as axiomatic for an unbiased historian as the historicity of Julius Caesar. It is not historians who propagate the Christ myth theories." So here F.F. Bruce acknowledges, you know what? He says there was a Christ, and an honest historian recognizes it. It's not the historians that try to propagate this. It's the so-called theologians and those who are atheists. You have to destroy Christ if you're going to destroy Christianity. Well, if there is the Christ of the Bible, if he is in fact an historical character, what are we going to do with him? Let me suggest you consider this. The Christ of the Bible is asking us to enjoy the very best of life. He wants us to be students of his word. Romans chapter 10, verse number 17 says, "Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God." Hebrews 11 and verse 6 says that without faith, it's impossible to please him. God does not want us to approach him ignorantly. He wants us to get to know him so that we can have a relationship with him. And that is only possible when we study his word. We need to accept the evidence of Scripture and believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. John chapter 8, verse number 24. We need to be willing to redirect our lives, repent, and live in accordance with the will of God. Luke 13, 3 and 5. We need to be willing to confess our faith in Christ. Matthew 10, 32 and 33. And we must be willing to be baptized for the forgiveness of sins. Mark 16, 16. When the Apostle Paul retold his own conversion experience, he told how Ananias came to him and said, "And now why are you waiting? Arise and be baptized," now get this, "and wash away your sins." What are you going to do with Jesus? Join us again next week.